Fort Leavenworth, Kansas has been known historically as the intellectual center of the Army. However, long before its prestige and recognition was established, Fort Leavenworth played a key part in our nation's history and westward expansion. It is the third oldest continuously active military reservation in the United States and the oldest U.S. Army fort in continuous existence west of the Mississippi. In 1827, Colonel Henry Leavenworth led an expedition along the Missouri River, searching for the perfect location for a cantonment. Instructions were given to him to establish a fort along the east bank of the river, but Leavenworth found this location was not adequate, as he believed there would be too much flooding. He decided the west side of the river would be a more beneficial location. Infantry and artillery troops were stationed at the fort with Colonel Leavenworth. Establishment of the fort was a protection for trade along the Santa Fe and Oregon trails, as well as protection against Native Americans in the surrounding areas. On May 8, 1827, Colonel Leavenworth wrote a letter to E.G. W. Butler. In this letter, the location of Fort Leavenworth and its advantages are described for Mr. Butler. I can safely say that there is no other place that will answer the purposes required within the prescribed distance of the Little Platte. He also spoke about the local Indians in the letter, believing that they would soon be visiting the fort as well. After the site was approved in September 1827, it was named Cantonment Leavenworth after Colonel Leavenworth. As Leavenworth predicted, the fort did have a lot of interaction with the local Native American tribes. The fort spent time establishing relationships with and guarding the Indians, as well as punishing those who tried to disturb the peace there. Soldiers at Fort Leavenworth would escort doctors to the Indian reservations and expel squatters on their land. During the Indian Removal Act in 1830, Fort Leavenworth played a key role in helping to keep the peace with various Indian tribes. In 1832, the name of the fort was changed from Cantonment Leavenworth to Fort Leavenworth. As settlers moved west along the Santa Fe and Oregon trails, the fort provided a great spot for trade. Its location was the furthest spot west accessible by river travel. Settlers used this as their opportunity to get last-minute supplies they needed before finishing their trip west. As mentioned previously, the soldiers of Fort Leavenworth also provided protection along the trail for the western settlers from the Native Americans. In 1846, as the Mexican War broke out, Kearny's Army of the West departed from Fort Leavenworth. It then became a major supply depot for the soldiers and armies of the West. When Kansas Territory was organized in 1854, Governor Reeder set up his territory capital at Fort Leavenworth. There were four official capitals of Kansas in succession: Fort Leavenworth, Pawnee, Shawnee Mission, and Lecompton. While we all know that the capital was officially named Topeka, it is interesting to know that this fort was used as a capital for the governor. After the Civil War, in 1866, Fort Leavenworth established the 10th Cavalry Regiment, who, along with other regiments, became known as the Buffalo Soldiers. This unit consisted of predominantly African-American soldiers and was commanded by Colonel Benjamin H. Grierson. These soldiers had to face enormous obstacles as African-American soldiers as a result of their race. The Army had a hard time finding leaders for these regiments, and it was often hard for them to find adequate weapons and uniforms, but they overcame the prejudice and fought in many fights with Native Americans along the frontier, becoming distinguished throughout the territory. The regiments of the Buffalo Soldiers are honored at Fort Leavenworth with a Buffalo Soldier Monument that was erected in 1992. The United States Disciplinary Barracks was established at Fort Leavenworth in 1875. The USDB is a military prison established to hold male servicemen that were convicted. It is the only maximum security prison within the Department of Defense. The old building is still standing in Fort Leavenworth today, but it is no longer being used as the prison. The new USDB was opened in September 2002 and allows room for over 500 prisoners. In 1881, General Sherman established a school for application of infantry and cavalry at Fort Leavenworth for soldiers. The school has since evolved into what is now known as the United States Army Command and General Staff College. It has become known as the finest senior tactical school in the world for advanced military education. This school has trained and equipped the soldiers of the United States Army to be prepared for war. Many of our great military and political leaders have studied or been stationed at Fort Leavenworth. Some recognizable names among the alumni are World War II generals George Marshall, Douglas MacArthur, George Patton, Dwight Eisenhower, Omar Bradley, and Matthew Ridgway, as well as Generals Colin Powell and David Petraeus. CGSC, as the school is commonly referred to, continues to train soldiers in leadership and warfare today. Since its founding, Fort Leavenworth has continued to undergo changes as the post has developed. It has protected Indians and settlers moving west, it has brought up great military leaders, and continues to play a key role in training and developing soldiers today. There are several monuments on post honoring great military leaders and events in history. In 1960, the fort was named a National Historic Landmark. The entire post is etched with history, waiting to be discovered.